5 hours, marking resource, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And you'll get 5 hours for the rate. What?
Where are the other languages?
Where it says language.
Oh, that's all?
No, it'll be for one day.
We were just saying there's video on training on this, and where would you find that?
Okay, let's go back to home. You remember home, we're back at home, we're gonna go to Learn Center. All the trainings live on Learn Center. And when you get out to Learn Center, then you choose how you're gonna take classes. I would say take, if you can sign up for live classes, Resource Center 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, I would take it. There's lead resource, which is the CRM stuff, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. They all live in the calendar, but we've also recorded them over here. So just play around, see what you want to take. Does that make sense? That help? You really have to see this 4 or 5 times there. Oh, that's what that meant. The other way, if you like to read, you can learn by reading all the instructions, which my eyes glaze over. I can't learn that way. But you can also go to course catalog, find all the courses, and learn that way. If you learn by reading, browse for training. Browse for training.
Claudia?
Yeah.
What about, you know, when you're wanting to sit with a client for to do a listing, and you want to show them what had sold, and that you have the active and the pending and the sold.
You've got to use the MLS to get that.
Okay, that's what I've been using. I was wondering if you had it in there. Okay.
Yeah, no, that you insert into these templates that the PowerPoint's in.
Okay.
All right, so she just showed you, these are some canned things, trainings. So here's a 10 marketing secrets to supercharge your luxury business. It's a handout. If you like to learn that way, what they did live, and you want to read the handout, print it off or read it online. Where did I find that? Up here under course catalog, browse for training. Top.
That's actually a nifty thing, because if somebody's actually had a live training and you don't have time to go to it, but you're sitting around in a quiet area to sit through and read through a training session, it's maybe not the same, but it's not a bad second.
Yeah.
I've done that before.
Yeah. If you learn by reading, I have to see it, and then I can read it, and then it makes sense, but I'm very visual first.
There's one other thing you can do with this, and I'll help you if this sounds interesting to you. You can download all of their written material as PDFs into a file folder, okay? It says BHA's training, all of it. It's very small. It won't take up a lot of space on your computer. You can then go to that folder in an Internet or a Windows Explorer, type the word that is associated with what you want to learn. It'll only bring up the documents to talk about that and tell you where it is. You could literally say, I want to learn how to do, you know, I don't pick a topic, and you could search that word, and you could find it in all tons of, you could do that in the Library of Congress. You could type a keyword and find every time it's mentioned in the whole Library of Congress, like that, with a computer.
Yeah.
So.
More rabbit holes.
It's a good
more
idea.
Rabbit holes. We have one.
I'll actually take the time to go ahead and download that folder onto our network, and that way you'll have it, so you guys don't have to do that. But then just open that folder, and in the search bar of a Windows Explorer, type in the subject, and you'll find it.
Cool. One more thing I want to touch on, because somebody asked about contacts. So let's leave Learn Center, go back home. Now, it says signed out. You know what happened? We were gone from home so long. It said, Claudia, you went to bed. Night night. So all you have to do is sign back in, or just click on it. It's definitely not too long. Don't get nervous, because the word home isn't there, is what I'm trying to say. So now we're back home. To do contacts, they live in two places. They live in Lead Resource, which we're not even going to touch on today. They also live in the Marketing Resource. So hit Marketing Resource. Now, leads, I mean your contacts. Tell me you've got them on a 3x5 note cards, or they're in Gmail, or they're in Top Producer. If they're anywhere online, you go where they are, and you find the export button. It's somewhere on that site. Every venue is different. But you find your export button. Export your contacts. If you can remember, it's going to say, how do you want to export? If you can remember, CSV.
We'll do it for you. Just tell us where it is. We'll do it for
Alan,
you.
Alan, go back to home and
Alan
show me again what you click.
Marketing
resource.
And then this page will come up.
And hit contacts at the top. Are you all with me?
Yep.
Contacts. So, before we click anymore, you're off, you're getting your contacts, or Ellen will do it, maybe Mark. Grab your contacts from wherever they are. Export them as CSV file to your computer. Where do I save everything? What?
The export?
Don't try to do it right now.
Couldn't you import contacts?
Just a minute. Yeah, then you import. But you got to export them first. You got to get them. Save them to your computer. And then you've got to fix that file. It's an Excel file. And you know there's rows and there's columns. In the doesn't have to be first column, but in one column is a first name, another column a last name, and in another column email. Marketing resource is an email system. It doesn't need to know the birthdays of the kids. It doesn't need to know the street address of the house they live in or anniversary date of when they bought. That's lead resource. You want to save that Excel spreadsheet. But you want to make sure of all, you can have 100 rows going over, columns, rows. But the only three things that we're going to upload into this site is first name, last name, and email. Now, when you export, every system exports a little bit differently. It yours might have Bill and Mary and one cell, Jones and another, okay? If it's Bill and Mary, you've got to get one of their names out of there. Because it's got to be first name, one person, last name, one, that last name, and then email address. Here's a tip. The system never does last name. So if you don't know somebody's last name, just put a Z there or a T, the letter. It doesn't matter what you put in that, but make if you don't know 30 people's last name, just put T by all of them. That way you'll know if you ever do find them and you find out their last name, you can go back in there and change it from a T to their last name. Don't make up a name because then you won't know which one's right. But if you put a T, just some kind of placeholder in that last name cell, then you're ready to first name, last name, and email address, and you're ready to upload. So we hit contacts. You see where it says import contacts? That's your next step. So first you export them from where they are, fix them and put them on your computer, then and I save everything to my desktop because I'm going to save it somewhere else. I don't know where to find it. And I hit import contacts. It's going to say, okay, Claudia, we're going to browse. Where are they? Where did I tell you I saved my things?
Desktop.
So I click on it, and we're on your computer. But and then you find it. And then you click, and then it's, then and we're not going to get, oh, here we are. Here are the steps you're going to go through. The first thing is to find them. The second one is to map the fields, which first name, last name, and email. The third thing is handle duplicates. You leave that button alone, and here's why. Handling duplicate means if you put people in groups, and you've got five groups, and you've got somebody named Mary, and she's your wife, she plays soccer, same church, five different groups. You've got her in all five groups. If you leave that handle duplicate thing alone, then that means the system knows to only send her one e-card. Because she's in five groups, doesn't mean she's going to get five of them. She'll only get one. And then the select groups, then right when you've got that button open, you can put somebody into a group. Family group, church group. Basically, though, this system, when you send out a holiday card, it's going to go to everybody. You don't really need to have groups. Mm-hmm. Lead resource, you need groups. Mm-hmm. You need to do more of that. But this, it really can be everybody. And if you're going to send a birthday card to somebody, you're going to find their name and just send it to them anyway. Okay? And then confirm and import. Once you click that last step, bingo, it tells you how many you've got and how many problem kids you've got that didn't upload. And then it's okay. Just keep that spreadsheet, fix it, do some more to it, and and then it, you add it, and it'll just fix the things that need to be changed.
It won't double your...
Nope.
Okay.
Yes.
To kind of make it, what she's saying, set up for us, if you come to me with a handwritten list of names and emails, we'll put them in. I just want the names. There's no excuses for this. We'll take care of it. If you, all your names are on your phone, I'll show you how to put them into Google. I'll do this for you, okay? I need, all I need will then be the passwords to whatever account they're in, okay? And your password to this. You should be, keep what you want private, but on the business ones, you should be sharing your passwords and sign-ins with Ellen so she can help you real quick and you won't forget them, okay? You change your password, email that change to her. We're trying to keep a master list. You might say, can you help me out by putting a flyer together? I'm really busy. I've got 18 customers coming this week. Great. That's what we want. Okay. That's why we have help. So just send us something. But we can't, if we can't get into your account, because a lot of you guys come to me and you sit down with me and I'm going to help you, but you don't remember your passwords. And you spend a half an hour trying to figure out just how to get into it before I can do anything.
One of you should have access where you can go in as somebody in the office. I don't remember what that role is. The hotline can help you.
Administrator, usually.
Okay, let's close out of this, okay, because I want to show you where groups live. So here are all my contacts. I don't know, I have a couple hundred maybe. And then I, to see groups, see here my contacts, hit groups. I've got these groups. And if I want to delete a group, like this is you guys. And I had 20, well, how many is that? 28. I sent you all a card after I got home.
Right.
Yeah. Some of you got it. So I made a group. I don't keep the groups because things change. Like, there are how many of you in the room today that were part of that. So it's work for me to keep up on thousands of people. So, but the people that I have to communicate with all the time, they're right there. And I always have a me. Because whenever you send anything to anybody, you want to make sure you send it to yourself too. Especially if you schedule it to go out later. Let's say you're going to do your Halloween cards right now for October. I guarantee you when you October rolls around, somebody says, thank you for your email. You go, email? What did I send them? But if you get it when they do, then you'll remember.
So put yourself as a contact.
You're automatically in there as a contact. The system put you in there. So, and all I'm saying is if you're going to send out anything, make sure that you click on yourself, too, to get it. Yeah, me. Because you're a group. I made myself a group by myself. And then just click yourself, and then you'll get it, too. Any questions? You toggle between contacts and groups.
This is the goal for this month. Get all your contacts in. Any help you need, ask for it, but we want to really load this thing up.
So, how do you add, that was what I was going to do. How do you add a contact? Add contact, the box comes up, you need first name, last name, and email. You type that in. If you only have one contact that you met at an open house, you want to add them, then you add and close. But if you've got 10 you want to add right now, you first name, last name, email, add. First name, last name, email, add. It pops the box right back to you, so you can add all 10 really fast. And then when you're, and then when you're done, it you the last one, then you would add and close. And then they're in your system, ready to drip on them. I used to think it was so hard. You know, they made it sound hard. Maybe it got easier as time went on, or we're all getting a little more used to the computer. But it really isn't that hard to do. And you've got Ellen and Mark to help you, so put them in. Berkshire Hathaway does not do anything with your contacts. They are yours. So there's nothing to worry about on that.
And you won't send anything that you don't know about and approve of for your customers, okay?
Yeah. This is for you to drip to everybody you know and just keep the ball spinning so when they want to buy or sell, they think of somebody that does, they'll think of you because you've stayed in touch.
Do you find that people change the email address, especially when they move from city to city?
You know, we had that at the very beginning. Everybody was AOL, and then they switched, and then they switched, and then they switched. But really, everybody keeps their cell phone number and their email today. There isn't much change. Do you see any changes?
My customer told them to switch emails as they move into the field.
You'll know quicker if you do this. If you're doing drip emails, you're gonna have a very clean list. You're gonna get, I assume the returns come to us.
Oh, yeah, you see the analytics.
Bounce back every time.
You'll see the bounce, you'll see people that opt out. If somebody's opted out, let's go to that real quick. Go back, we wanna get out of this, we wanna go, just X out of this front bar, yep, tab. And now we're here, remember now this is the front page of resource, marketing resources. This, remember the analytics are at the bottom? So scroll down, and let's find one that I sent. I published, what does this one say?
Peak producers.
Yeah, hit that one. And I want to look at the activity. And I had 9 unique viewers, a total of 86 views, and 14 click-throughs. So I can scroll down and see the analytics. So if I click viewed, what you click viewed, then it sorts it even more. It shows me the 11 people, or the people that looked at it, and how many times they looked at it. So Dennis Rosas, is that Dennis Rosas? He looked 29 times at that e-card. Now if that was a flyer on a listing, I'd be calling him. But it was, he's using it for training. These are all leaders in their companies. And he's using it in the company. Let's say, and scroll down, I don't think anybody opted out. Oh,
no, it says zero.
Zero opted out. Yeah. If I bug them too much, people are going to opt out. So you want to be careful. But I don't get any opting out. But let's say it opted out. I would say it. Then you can click a down arrow over there, and it says opt in. And you click on that, and a nice little email box pops up. And you can personalize it and say, gosh, I see that you opted out. I would love to have you opt back in. Promise I won't bug you, blah, 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 whatever you want to write. And then send it, and they opt back in. Because lots of times they don't remember that they opted out. But that nice little email pops up for you just to send right back and ask them to opt back in.
The opt-out button, does that block my personal email somewhere, just this content?
Just here.
Okay.
So if I were bugging you and you opted out, it's just this site, not everything I send you. So
okay, sure.
And you can opt back in, and I would ask people to opt back in. So anyway, that's all the analytics. And then you can see who didn't view it, send it to them again. If you don't want to take the time to add your contacts, even if you just start with family and send a Labor Day card to your family, see how that works, see how it feels, and then start with people. If you've been in business 20, 30 years, you've got a lot of people you know. And you maybe don't know their email address, right?
Mm-hmm. I don't
have
them, don't even.
What?
I said a lot of my old customers don't even have emails.
Mm-hmm. That's because they're old.
That's what I just said.
You know what? You're stuck with a postage stamp then, right?
Yeah, I got it.
But for the people that use email, save that. It's almost 50 cents now per thing. And you can aim drip email. So your goal is to think of everybody you know, all areas of your life, and put them down in first name, last name, and email address, and then get them into the system.
And if you do have a lot of people without email addresses, but you do have live addresses, I'll show you how to do those in the Rezio software.
Okay.
We do have a database that will work for those. Okay, I'll put them in there, and we can do drip campaigns out of there.
Okay.
Okay. But the first thing you're going to mail them is send your email address.
Oh, that was the. Did I share that with you? I was in Texas, and a lady, this was like, well, when internet was pretty new, 15 years ago, 20 years ago, and she had a, I don't know why she did this, she had a 10,000 home farm, and she sent mailings out to them. And when the internet was pretty new, she wrote and said, if you'd like to help me save a tree, remember my saying this? Email me at, and I will email you my newsletter. And over half of her farm said, yes, let's save a tree, and sent her their email address. So she, number one, could send out, she didn't have to lick envelopes and stamps. She could send out, just poof, half of them. And within a few times of writing, she got the majority of the people saying, yes, email me. And she saved a boatload of money from printing to stamps. So that's a way. If you'd like to help me save a tree, email me at, that goes in your letter that you mail. Thanks for bringing that up. Do I have anything else that, or make sure that...
Claudia, is there a business or company name? It all has to be personal name. You say first name, last name. What if it's a business that a person wants to have information sent to his business, not to him personally? Is there a way to do that?
Well,
Always personal.
It's always personal.
Okay.
You wouldn't want to send it to the general mailbox or company anyway. You'd want to send it to Joe Smith of ABC.
Is there any place to put the company's name so you know?
Yeah, you can put it all over that spreadsheet. You just don't capture it on this. In Lead Resource, you capture all that kind of stuff.
Thanks.
Yeah, all your little tips, your notes, everything go in Lead Resource. So when you get that spreadsheet exported from somewhere, save it, because all that information will go into that site. The only thing we're going to save in this is first name, last name, and email. Actually, it's called do not store, do not store, do not store. And when it's first name, last name, and email, you want to store that in this site. The rest is all do not store.
So you can write about the person? Notes, you can make a note.
In Lead Resource.
No notes in this. Notes go in Lead Resource.
Okay, that's the one you said.
I'm not even touching on today, because you can take classes on Lead Resource. In fact, I recommend you take classes on what I just shared today, because you're going to get 5 hours where I've had 90 minutes.
I know, it's so uncomfortable.
The other thing that I didn't, did I miss it on my thing, but Videolicious, I talked about Videolicious. Has anybody done a Videolicious?
No, I haven't.
Okay.
What's that?
So it lives right there where it says video creation. Don't click on it because I've already connected. But you can, back in Learn Center, if you start typing up in that top right search bar, Videolicious, you can watch a video on how to do Videolicious. Okay? The reason we do it, and there's no charge for doing this, is because we know the consumer doesn't want to just look at pictures anymore. They want to see video. They want to see things moving. So if you click on 10 photos that you've taken of a property or a neighborhood or whatever, and you click on them, then when you get done doing the Videolicious thing, by doing pictures, talking to it, selecting music, it right-sizes and puts the front and the back and makes it all beautiful, then the photos actually go like this. So it looks like it's a video when it's 10 photos. You can upload videos too.
Learning Center.
Huh?
She's trying to find it in the homepage. She needs to go to Learning Center to find it.
The class?
She's searching Videolicious in the homepage.
Oh, no, you've got to go Learn Center and type Videolicious. Learn Center. Do you have sound right here?
That's not video.
Yeah.
Type Videolicious.
Yeah, speakers.
Okay, there it is. You're just too fast, Ellen. Okay, stop a second. That's to take the class. Hit it. Video, start the L, because it's got his, these are just video L, put an L there. And that's to take the class.
Do you have to go into the video training app before you search?
No, it just sorted too much, because there was a video somewhere here, video training, you could watch it, okay? Okay, so we... Just so that you know, there's a training, the video. It says it's only for iPhones. You guys, when that was made, it was only for iPhones, because you only had to do one geeky thing, and all iPhones work. With Androids, every Android had to be added to the system. So we think we got all of them, but you might have an Android that we don't have yet. If it doesn't work, what are you going to do? Call the hotline and say, I've got the Android, blah, 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 whatever it is. They'll get it so that it can work.
If there's one that's too old to exist,
we'll have it. So, and then you can take a class on Videolicious if you want to. It's cool. Do you want to see one that I made up?
Sure.
Yeah, yeah, sure.
Okay. So go, where does it live? By the way, when you go to Marketing Resource and you click on that video creation, it asks for another password in your life. But then what happens is your phone beeps. And now your phone, you do everything right here on your phone. This isn't mine, but it looks like mine. And you pick the 10 photos, let's say 10 photos of 10 of a listing. And then you tap and talk about the property, and then you pick the music, and then it's done. Now, X out of here. So when you're done with, when you've done it here, then you come back to Marketing Resource. So where are we? We're in Marketing Resource, and we go to My Library, not the Master Library, but My Library. It's just one of 20 ways to find it. And why don't you write video up there? Because it's a video. Videolicious is a video in My Library. Now, My Library in a Perfect World is going to pop up when you hit search, and only the videos that I've made. So it lives here. The minute I pick one, I can send it out to social media or to somebody. So where, I didn't title it right, which I next time would, but scroll down. Keep going down.
What's that say? Next generation video.
No.
Homeware segment survey video. Video MP4.
No. Keep going down. All these flyers have video.
You got too much time.
Video for recruiting.
You got too much time on your hands.
These are great videos to watch. I might add my Videolicious video. You guys, I'm novice. I don't know what I'm doing. But I had fun with it. I don't even remember which one this is. Hit the arrow. We want to keep it small. Keep it small. I don't want you to see my big face.
Full screen.
No,
full screen.
Hello from Dallas, Texas. We just finished our 2016 convention, and what a great hit it was. Arriving in Dallas, I went right to the JFK Memorial, and then to the hotel where I saw the mobile oil statue out in front. Walked over to a wonderful display of metal of herding cows. And during convention, we heard some great speakers, went to AT&T Stadium, had pictures taken with ex-football players, went through the locker room, had my photo taken under the Dallas Cowboys star, and we ended the convention hearing Huey Lewis and the News. What an awesome event. And here's a photo with Karen and myself, our new Hawaii company, and Karen being one of the top agents. What a great event it was. Look forward to seeing you in Phoenix in 2017. Have a great year.
Okay, so I learned a lot by that. Number one, where to look, because I wasn't looking at the dot. I was looking down.
I have a question. How did your hair grow so long in 1 year?
Yeah. I haven't gotten mad at it, so it's still growing. But I should go short. Every time I get a cut, I go, I can never grow it out. But anyway, and what else? I would know to call them steer, longhorn, whatever. They're not cows. But, you know, after I watched it back, I'd go, oh, dang, why did I do that? So you play with it a little bit. So what would I do if I were agent today? Fairwood Golf and Country Club was where I farmed. I would go, I would take a picture at the entrance, couple of the houses, the school, the swimming pool at the clubhouse, a tea, a hole, and then I, and the Starbucks, because there was a Starbucks.
And then you come to me and get a nice splice out of the neighborhood drone video that we have. And
ooh, yeah, you can upload videos here too, by the way.
You could do a flyover clip in there too.
Yep. And then they're on your phone, because you do it all on your phone, and you click the photos you want to have in this in the order you want them to show up. So this one, that one, in whatever order. And then the next thing it says is now you're going to talk. This is the scary part. Because you're going to see yourself, and you're going to go, I don't like looking at myself. So I want to say get over it, because everybody likes you. And you, what I do, what I learn now, is you click on that first photo faster. Because you're talking into it, but then if you're clicking on the first photo, that's what shows up when it's done. And you talk about the how, the pictures that you got, tap and talk and tap and talk and tap and tap, tap the top. When you're done with the last one, you tap back to your face and it comes back to you, and then there's the call to action. You know, if anybody wants to live in this fine neighborhood, please let me know. And then stop. And then add the music, and then it's done. And then you come back here to your marketing resource that lives in my library because you did it, and now you can send it off to the world.
And the file size on that, is that work as far as
it right emails? Sizes it automatically.
Okay.
Put that logo thing on the front where you sell Berkshire Hathaway Home Services, and at the back, it just does it all. Like, lickety split. I literally, convention was over, I was still sitting in my room, it was morning, so I still have my morning voice, which I'm gonna do. And so I was sitting there, I go, oh, I'm just gonna play with this Videolicious app, because it was new then to me. And I just sat there and did it. I'd do it again if I was gonna publish it, but it was just something to show you that if I can do it, you can do it.
Two quick things. One other use for this is I used to do YouTube videos, walkthroughs of homes. People say, can you take a peek at it? And I just used to walk through and narrate it as I went through, created a big upload file, send them a link. This is an easier way to do it. It also takes out the, okay, I'm going up the stairs now, you know, and all that stuff. And go around, say you were doing a, you were doing the walkthrough, they were closing by mail. Take a picture of the main part of the house, take a picture of the three things that were supposed to be repaired. And then just say, I've checked everything out. As you see, the place is really clean. And you'll also see that the stove has been fixed and the plumbing has been fixed and whatever. Just want to let you know I went through. That's another useful way to use this.
Cool.
And then the second thing I want to say is I just want to reiterate something. If you go out and buy Microsoft Office for a year, it's $99, we pay for it. If you want to go get a mobile website on your own, Sharper, what do they call it? Smarter Agent, it's $50 a month, okay? They're subsidizing it like crazy, and we're paying for the rest of it. This is something, if you go on to Videolicious, it costs money to get this. That's something Berkshire Hathaway, in other words, instead of us just sending 6% to a dead company, we're getting a ton of support from Berkshire Hathaway. They're taking care of a lot of our needs. And these are the kind of things that your competition is always paying for out of pocket. And because they're paying for it out of pocket, most of them don't. Most of them don't add these things to the mix. So you have a chance to stick out with stuff like this.
When I first got knew about the Videolicious, I went to the app store and got Videolicious and saw that it was costing money and stuff. It didn't connect with me because they hadn't done a video yet to teach me. That you start in marketing resource where it says video creation. That's where you start, and then your phone beeps at you. So don't go to the app store first. This does it for you. And you want it connected to the marketing resource so you can send whatever you produce out.
Just because you're getting something for free doesn't mean it doesn't have a lot of value.
Oh my goodness.
Somebody is paying for these things, and you know, we're trying to earn our keep on our split, okay? And certainly, we're getting a lot more than we ever expected from Berkshire Hathaway.
So these are my favorite tools. Play with them, mess with it. Just pick one and play with it. Whatever your needs are. Any questions? I'm going to stick around for another hour. So if you want to bring your laptops in here, you want me to go to your desk, if there's anything you're frustrated with, you want to learn, I'm here to help. If you haven't got in yet and you can't get in, call the hotline. Get in and then I'll help you with your profiles. I would assume everybody that was here in May has their profiles all set, the photos and that kind of thing. Okay.
Well, thank you.
Thank you.